A few months ago, I was interviewed for a newspaper article, and I was asked by this very young journalist, what do you say, in your opinion, is the most successful thing that APE Lanka has done? And I did answer that question. But it's a question that went on in my mind, and I kept asking myself, what is the most successful thing that APE Lanka has done over the last 3-4 years? Is it, as Shehara says, that we have given 21 schools water purifying systems in 18 months? No, I don't think that's what is most successful. Is it successful then that we have given 300 plus children push bicycles and prevented them from dropping out of school and not being educated anymore? Is that a success story? It is not a success story. Is it then that we have done peace and reconciliation workshops through the use of sports and arts and produce paintings and drawings like you see behind there? Is that our success story? Or is it the solar systems we've given? Is it the computers we have given? Is it then that we have taught English to try and get these children employable when they leave school? And most certainly, I believe that that is not our success story. Then what is our success story? Is it that we have built partnerships with the Rotary Club of Colombo and the Rotary Club of Regency, who has given us water purifying systems? Or is it that we have been able to tie up with organizations like the Roundtable 5, with ICBC or Spa Ceylon or any of these organizations that helped us? No, that is not the successful thing that we have done over the years. Is it that we have tied up with places like Maniampathy and worked with musicians and artists and opinion leaders? No. If none of those things is our success story, the question I asked myself for months after that interview is, what is the most successful thing about APE Lanka? And I believe that the most successful thing about APE Lanka is very simple. It is what has made all of these things possible. What has made all of these things possible is because people cared enough to dare. They cared enough to give of themselves, to give of their resources, to give of their time, to work one with the other in whatever way possible, to do what they can to help a people who are in need. I believe today that Sri Lanka is in crossroads like never before. And we have this wonderful opportunity available to us for a very short period of time to stretch out our hand and help those people to make a change. Are we going to be like the children of St. Thomas's College who walked into the field when they were playing a football match in Poonahari and took off their shoes because they noticed that the children were playing barefoot? They made that choice. They made that choice. Are we going to be like little Dinesh Bhutani, my business partner's son, who was 5 years old, who overheard this conversation, talking to his parents, saying, you know, children are dropping out of school. You know, what are we going to do about it? And he came up to me and said, Aunt Shan, I'm so sad. Here is my till. I don't want a toy. Can you buy the child a bike? Maybe that till did not have enough money for one bicycle. But he chose and he took some action. I remember very clearly that when we started this water project And Mr. Krishnendran told me that there were 21 schools in Poonahari that did not have safe, usable water. I just thought to myself, you know what, this cannot be done. It's absolutely not possible for an organization like Apelanka to give water to 6,500 children. And I tried to put it out of my mind. But every morning I got up and I made myself a cup of coffee or I had a bath. I just remembered that it doesn't matter that they didn't have water from a tap. They didn't have safe water, period. And then I decided that somehow we were going to give these children water. We made a choice. And Mr. Rajan Asirvadan, who's not here today, unfortunately, said, you know what, Sean? Just one at a time. One at a time. Today, we have a choice to make. If an organization, if a people, if a society, if a village like Poonahari stretch out their hand to us, we need to grasp it. We need to grasp it unconditionally. We need to grasp it with love. And we need to try to do what we can in any way possible to help these people. It's our choice. And that is the success story of Apelanka. A few weeks ago, or maybe a few months ago, when I went up to Poonahari with Shehara, we had this meeting to try and work out what we were going to do in this one village that had 495 families, the GN division of Ponnavali. And the whole purpose was to find out from them what they need. At the end of the meeting, this lady came up to me and she gave me a hug. And she said, thank you. And I remember looking at her and saying, what are you thanking me for? I haven't done anything. And her answer was, because you care. Let's today take this window of opportunity available to us and let's create an Apelanka we are proud to call our home.